The meeting of the Alcohol Beverage Board for Thursday, January 8th, 2015, is hereby called to order. First off, everybody, very happy New Year in 2015. Real quick introductions. Myself, I'm Moses Aldani, the chair. To my left is Ms. Linda Palczynski, the vice chair. Ms. Betty Curry, a member. Mr. Aaron Mathis, a member. The extreme left is Mr. Gordon Thompson, our board inspector. To my right is Mr. Kevin Hall, member. Ms. Tammy Hillebrand is our board administrator. Mr. James Sinavich is our board attorney. Corporal James Stone is
on his way.
Funny late, but he is our alcohol enforcement coordinator. And Susie Wilden also assists Tammy there in the office. So, again, welcome. I have a real quick note. There's a sign-in sheet. Is it outside, Tam?
Susie,
it's right here.
Okay, right here. So anyone that would like to speak today during the meeting, please make sure your name gets on that list. We'll proceed on to the agenda. First order of business is the approval of minutes. Like the motion from the board for approval of the minutes for the Thursday, December 11th, 2014 meeting.
I make a motion we approve the minutes for the Alcohol Beverage Board meeting Thursday, December 11th, 2014.
I have a motion and a second. Second from the vice chair. Okay. Any discussion? Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That motion carries. And again, thanks to Fran Hammett for preparing these. Tammy, so we no longer have her services,
right,
correct?
Susie's working on the minutes today.
Excellent. Again, I think that last meeting we presented Franny a token of appreciation.
Yeah.
Again, we really appreciate her work there with those minutes.
She wanted me to share with the board that she very much enjoyed working with the board. She's sorry she had to quit.
Likewise with her.
Mm-hmm. Okay, moving right into new business. We have several applications that we're going to consider today. Real quick before we proceed into those, what I'll do is just a quick overview of how we handle applications here. First, obviously, you'll be called individually up to present the reason behind your application. And at that time, we'll hear some testimony from the individuals. The there are some things that we need to consider for the application. Part of it is defined in Article 2B. It's a Section 202. We'll ask some questions that pertain to those various conditions or in the process of the approval. Once we hear some of the testimony, the questions are being asked, exchanged, I'll ask for any protests from the audience. And you can, the applicants are also allowed to ask questions if there's anyone protesting. If you would like to bring someone up on your behalf to support your application, that's okay as well. What we'll do is we'll get anyone that has going to provide any statements or comments that we will need you to come and be sworn. So that being said, what I'd like to do is hear the first application, which is Blue Wind, application of Dana Rybarczyk to transfer Blue Wind Gourmet TBD Restaurant LLC Class Beer Class B Beer, Wine, and Liquor License from Robert Plant and trade as Blue Wind Gourmet, MGR Inc., 22803 Gunston Drive, California, Maryland, 20619. So please,
Need you to both raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you are about to give is the truth and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you. You need to come up here and have a seat.
And real quick, name and address for the record, please.
Dana Rybarczyk, 45191 Scotch Neck Road, Hollywood, Maryland, 20636.
Robert Plant, and it's 43220 Jonquil Lane, California, Maryland, 20619.
Great. Thank you. Okay. And just a reminder that we did remove Mr. Barczyk from a previous license, I believe, last meeting. Right. All right. Floor is yours, ma'am. What would you like to do with the transfer?
I am looking to transfer Rob's Blue Wind license into my name as I'll be leasing the building and continuing with the current Blue Wind Gourmet.
Okay. So basically everything just transfers over, the premise, the everything that's already been previously established.
Correct.
When, and as far as your hours of operation and your menu and everything else more or less remains the same, is that correct?
Correct.
Okay, so the same display of the products?
Yes.
Okay. And Garland, you've been
Blue Wind.
Right. So everything is, we're good.
Right. Everything, no additional buildings, no additional, just same in setting inside the dining area.
Correct. Everything will stay the same.
Storage in the same area.
Yes, sir.
This one is, for me anyway, I think she's an experienced licensee, so any other questions? You want to ask about cheese?
Yeah, cheese steaks.
Tammy, this is not...
not conditional.
Not conditional.
She got everything done by this morning, so she's good to go.
Okay. Alrighty, and as far as I know, there has been nothing in the office?
No.
Okay, the electronic means, you know, or letter, mail. Okay, so anything else?
No, sir.
Okay.
She's gonna...
Mr. Plant, so...
Well, of course, I'm gonna go on to Elements Eatery and Mixology, so you'll get an application from us for the next hearing.
Okay, so the plan, and that's one of the things, I just wanted a little clarification about.
It's moving.
So you're moving.
It's not going to San Sushi, it's going to go to Where the Tides.
Cheese steak.
Switching everything here.
Same menu, same concept. That's all moving. Dana's going to keep all the same high quality stuff that we do at Blue Wind. I'm taking her to two different farms tomorrow to introduce her to farmers and get product and that kind of stuff. So she's going to continue to buy local and do all those great things that we do. And of course, the Board of Health was out this morning, and Blue Wind is one of the six people that are going to be Gold Star this year for Board of Health, 6 out of, I think, 140.
Congratulations.
So she's going to continue all the good practices that we do there.
Okay. Very good. So, again, that was just a little clarification on what was going on because...
Yeah.
Because I had come before the board 2 months ago and...
Right. So that request has been pulled.
Withdrawn. Yes.
Right. Withdrawn. So, yeah. Okay. Alrighty. Any other questions? And again, this is not conditional, so they're ready for the transfer to be executed. At this time, I'd like to entertain any comments, protests from the audience. Okay, I hear none. So what I'd like to do is entertain a motion from the board for action on the Blue Wind application.
I'd like to make a recommendation that we approve the application of Dana Rybarczyk to transfer Blue Wind Gourmet TBD Restaurant LLC Class B-BWL license from Robert Plant and Traders Blue Wind Gourmet MGR Incorporated, 22803 Gunston Drive, California, Maryland, 20619.
Okay. I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second from Member Mathis. All right. I think we've, this one's pretty simple. All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good luck. Good luck.
Thank you.
Bring this over to the treasurer with Rob's license, and she'll issue you the new one. Yes, please. Thank you.
Okay, next I have Ridgel's Baymark, application of Joseph M. Ridgel and Karen D. Ridgel to transfer Baymark and Deli, Baymark Wine and Spirits, LLC, Class A1, beer, wine, and liquor license from Brian Patrick Gass and trade as Ridgel's Baymark, 16591 Three Notch Road, Ridge, Maryland, 20680.
Please raise your right hand. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you are about to give is the truth and nothing but the truth? Thank you. Have a seat up front.
Right. Please, one at a time, just name an address for the record.
Joseph Michael Ridgel, 17425 Friendly Way, Dameron, Maryland, 20628.
Aaron Denise Ridgel, 17425 Friendly Way, Dammer, Maryland, 20628.
Thank you. Tammy, is this everything is?
It will be conditional. We are still working on the fire marshal coming out, and then they'll be able to get their occupancy and their trailers.
So the UNO and the trader's license.
What was that, the fire marshal? What else?
UNO
and traders. And traders.
Okay. Who would like to be the spokesperson?
I will.
Okay. All right, so why don't you tell us what you want to do?
Looking to take over the Baymart to help support the community and make things a little bit better for the people in the first district, I hope. Bring some local business back in the area and I'll live the American dream.
So, again, experience with dealing with alcohol products and?
As far as selling, first time, we haven't been in a position to sell alcohol before. I mean, we've took the class, we have the TAMS class, that's done. Taken over from what we've been seeing done down there.
And again, I would recommend, you know, right now it's not a mandatory requirement that you attend the our RAS training,
mm-hmm.
but hopefully you've heard of that, you know, when you went into put in the application, Tammy should have told you about it.
Yes.
Okay, so again, I highly recommend that for you. Mr. Thompson is the our inspector, so if this your application is approved today, then you know you will see him.
Okay.
And more or less, my guidance to him is to he's there to assist.
Right.
Although it may be a little rough, you know, maybe the first time, especially because there'll be good lessons learned. And Corporal Stone, he's the enforcement coordinator. You know, I would like to promote that we are there to help you succeed and live that American dream, right? Okay, so, and any questions, you know, make sure that, you know, call Tammy. You know, about anything. The rules and regs?
The book?
Yep. Fine lime green, I think, is?
Yeah.
Covered book. Make sure you know that. It's important. And that, any questions? No. We're here to help. Again, that's one of my concerns. Anytime someone's new, that we would like you to succeed, and that's what we're here for, you know, to make sure that we've covered all the bases here in your application process. But from here on out, you know, the two of you together are responsible for the license, and any issues with selling to underage, you know, other, any violations to our local rules and regs or Article 2B will fall on your shoulders. Okay. Any questions? This is just going to transfer right over from the previous licensee, right? There's no changes at all?
No.
Everything
changes.
Goes right over. You're good?
There was a pizza area beside it, right?
Yes, sir.
Are you going to continue that area? Or
we're trying to get the deli back open, yes, sir.
And your stock and your storage be in the same area, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, nothing's changed.
You're good.
And that's one of the things that... It's kind of your opportunity to promote some of the things that you may. Are you going to bring changes to a menu or anything else?
Yeah, we're changing some. Trying to better. We're allowed a few seats where we can have people come in for breakfast or lunch or whatever and actually sit there instead of take it and leave. So.
So. For the benefit of those that may not know exactly where your premise is, where is it?
You want the address of it?
No, just to, maybe some landmarks that...
Ridge.
Right across from St. Michael's School in Ridge.
Mm-hmm.
Some people probably know it as the, used to be Ann and Tony's. It was a store that's been there for, I can never remember. It's always been a store, and they had lunch meats and stuff like that, but since Brian took it over when he bought it, mm-hmm. he put the deli in there, started his doodah.
Mm-hmm.
Got out of the doodah franchise, and it stayed as just a deli, so.
Right. So again, that's there's very, like you said, I think in your leading statement, is that there's very limited things available to the people that far south into Ridge and you know, further south in the county, so.
There's not many places to eat right now down there.
Right. Yeah. Which is somewhat sometimes I think is unfortunate, but hopefully you
it is.
You know, you can be successful and
we've had a lot of good people come in that you know, waiting for it to open. It's you know, wishing us well and like I say, we're born and raised there, so a lot of them have come in and hoping that we do well. Giving us their support.
Yeah. Very good. All right. And again this is there's no other further questions?
Conditional.
It's conditional. Pending fire, the UNO and traders. They have temp certification. Recommendation has been extended for the RAS training. Okay. And so at this time, I'd like to entertain a motion from the board for action on the Ridgels Bay Mart application.
I'll make a motion. That we approved the application of Joseph M. Ridgel and Karen D. Ridgel to transfer Bay Mart and Deli, Bay Mart Wine and Spirits LLC, Class A1 beer, wine, and liquor license from Brian Patrick Gass and trade as Ridgel's Bay Mart, 1659 Three Notch Road, Ridge, Maryland, 20680, conditional on the UNO, fire marshal, and traders.
Would you like to amend that to for the period of time?
How much time do you think you need? No.
30, 60, 90?
30 or 60 days.
I'd say 30. They've been there. I'm just waiting on them to sign off. And it's basically the fire marshal. I've contacted them. I'm not getting a response yet.
Maybe 60.
60-day conditional. That way.
Okay.
That's
fine.
Okay. All right. So I have a motion before the board for conditional approval pending fire UNO and traders for a 60-day period. Do I have a second?
A second.
Second from Member Mathis. Discussion on this? Again, this gives you that period of time. We could allow up to 90 days because it's an existing premise to get these
taken care of.
And basically just bring them into Tammy, and once that's satisfied, she'll pass you your license, and you'll get, pay the fee, and then you're off and running. Okay.
And I'll just say, just to follow up some things you said, just since you are new, make sure that you're being, communicating with Tammy if you need things. I mean, she's very helpful with that, and Corporal Stone, as well as our alcohol inspector as well, Garland. So they are willing to work with you. So take advantage when you can if you have questions.
Okay. Further discussion?
Lunch. Thank you.
All right. Any protests?
No.
Okay. Do I have anything from the audience? Okay. Hearing none. All right. That, I'd like to go to a vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Good luck.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, next I have Oga's Asian Cuisine, application of Ting Yang Zing, to purchase a Class B restaurant beer wine license and trade as Oga's Asian Cuisine, Oga's Asian Cuisine, LLC, 22745 Washington Street, Leonardtown, Maryland, 20650.
Well, raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you are about to give will be the truth and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you. You have a seat.
Real quick, just name an address for the record, please, sir.
My name is Ting Yen Zhang, so 41488 Pensive Street, Leonardtown, Maryland, 20650.
Great. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, and other distinguished members of the board. My name is Daniel Slade, and I represent Mr. Ting Yang Zing. Here and after, I'm going to refer to as Peter, if that's okay, and Oga's Asian Cuisine, LLC. We are here today under the application to purchase a Class B beer and wine license. We are requesting to purchase a license because it's become obvious that the ability to serve beer and wine to patrons is vital to compete against the other numerous restaurants in the area who provide a full-service dining experience. It would be the same license that was previously held at the exact same location. The applicant is seeking this license to enable them to fully serve their customers. Again, having the privilege to serve beer and wine would make it a better dining experience for the customer, enable them to compete with the surrounding restaurants in the area who provide the same service. It's very helpful not only to my clients, but to the community. They hire employees. They have employees there who rely on them to be able to keep their doors open to make a living. So we're here to request the Class B beer and wine license. If you'd like, may I be allowed to question my client?
Sure.
Okay. You've already stated your name and for address for the record. Are you a resident of St. Mary's County?
Yeah.
How long have you been a resident of St. Mary's County?
2005, so almost 10 years.
Okay. And are you a registered voter in St. Mary's County?
Yes. Yeah.
You a taxpayer of St. Mary's County?
Yes. Yeah.
And you are a member of the Oga's Asian Cuisine, LLC, is that
yeah.
correct?
Yeah.
Have you ever had a prior license for the sale of alcoholic beverages before?
Yeah.
And where was that?
Same address, 22745 Washington Street.
Okay. And have you ever had a license denied or revoked before?
No.
Have you ever been convicted of a felony crime?
No.
Have you ever violated any of the laws of the state of Maryland or any gambling laws? And you have a financial interest in this company, correct?
Yeah.
Does anyone else have a financial pecuniary interest in the company?
I think the owner, he, my friend, he has, yeah.
The other owner?
Yeah.
Your friend, who is that?
Yeah, his name is, last name, first name, Dad.
Okay. And does anyone else have a pecuniary interest in the company?
No.
If you're granted a license, you conform to all the laws and regulations applicable to the business in which you propose to engage? Is the company current on all its state and local tax obligations?
Yeah.
And do you have a combined registration number?
Yeah.
And you have all your workman's compensation insurance and everything up to snuff, is that correct?
Yes.
And your building is approximately 3,900 square feet?
Yeah.
And you guys are renting the building, is that correct?
Yeah.
And your landlord has already signed the consent for the board?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you understand that the board, through its investigator, Mr. Thompson, can randomly, without a warrant, inspect the premises and books of your establishment?
Yeah.
And you had a liquor license before, so you understand all the procedures and obligations that you're under. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Do you understand that you have to purchase all of your alcoholic beverage from a liquor wholesaler?
Okay.
And do you understand that you have to check the identification to follow the rules and regulations of everyone coming in there wanting to purchase an alcoholic beverage? And we discussed the RAS training that this board offers, is that correct? And your partner is going to sign up today to take the training on January 27th, I believe. Is that correct?
Yeah.
I have no further questions, Your Honor. If you board members have any other questions, feel free to ask of my clients.
Yeah, and just simply, is that the reason why you voluntarily returned the license?
Well, what happened was he sold the majority interest of the business. Someone else bought in. They terminated the license. They realized that they couldn't keep the business the way it was going without a beer and wine license, so they're reapplying.
Right.
It was just a business decision, and realized it was a mistake, and now they're back to get their license back.
Yeah, so I guess really here what I was trying to bring forward is that it wasn't revoked or wasn't, I mean, it was something voluntary. So again, it was just
it was a bad decision.
Yeah, well, not that it lapsed, but it's
right.
You know, it was, like you said, a business decision.
Correct.
Action from the board or anything that again, the new prospective licensee did wrong. So
correct.
As far as Tammy, is there
everything's in order?
Ready to go?
Yep.
Okay, so this is not not a conditional. So again, seems like everything is in order, and I appreciate your time, Mr. Slade, to get this process through relatively quick. Any other questions?
So who will be running the restaurant now?
Right now, a friend of mine, he bought my just so he be running the restaurant.
A friend of yours be running it?
Yeah.
And again, Mr. Zhang, you know that you are responsible for
yes,
everything. That's, you know, and again, this
yes,
nice little book, if you make sure that you and your employees and your managers and especially that staff. Okay. There's no further questions? Nothing else? Okay. What I'd like to do is entertain a motion from the board for action on Olga's Asian Cuisine.
I make a motion that we approve the application of Olga's Asian Cuisine, application of Ting Yang Zing to purchase a Class B restaurant BW license and trading as Olga's Asian Cuisine, Olga's Asian Cuisine LLC, 22745 Washington Street, Leonardtown, Maryland, 20650.
Before I go to that, sorry, anything, there was no petitions or against this, anything from the audience? Okay, I hear none. All right, so I have a motion before the board for approval. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second from Member Curry. All right, further discussion? Again, we have no protests. So. All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Good luck, sir.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Bring this to the treasurer. This is the renewal. You got to get this done right away, okay?
Next, I have an application of discount liquors, application of, I'm going to get the two of you to pronounce this properly for me after I try it. Quagar-e-Qureshi?
Qureshi, yeah.
Yeah, and Chastar Batal, to purchase a Class A1 beer, wine, and liquor license and trade as Discount Liquors, Atlantic LLC, 21591. Great Mills Road, Lexington Park, Maryland, 20653.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you are about to give will be the truth and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you. Have a seat.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mike Davis. I'm here representing the applicants for Discount Liquors. The name of the company is Atlantic LLC. They're applying for a Class A1 beer, wine, and liquor license at the current location of the Long John Silver restaurant, which is located on the north side of Great Mills Road in Lexington Park. I'd like to give you a little overview of what the applicants are going to tell you.
Real quick, Mr. Davis, before you start, I need your name and address for the record, please.
Waqar Qureshi, 5402 Tilapia Court, Waldorf, Maryland, 20603. And I'm the member.
Mr. Bedwal, will you give your name and address?
Sasita Bedwal, 20928 Joe Murrayway, Callaway, MD, 20620.
On the application, Mr. Qureshi, they have 20620. Is it, you said 206?
03.
Okay. Yep. Application, Tim?
Yeah. Let me carry it.
I want you to correct that. Waqar and Shoibar Qureshi are the members and owners of Atlantic LLC. They're 50-50 owners of that company. Waqar Qureshi is the managing member. And he's one of the applicants today. The other applicant is Mr. Bedwal. Mr. Bedwal is a resident of St. Mary's County and has lived here for a number of years. And he is the authorized person, authorized by the members of the company to serve as the authorized person, resident agent, if you will, on the license. I'd like to tell you a little bit about Mr. Qureshi. He's a businessman. He's the owner. He owns the property with another gentleman. The property where Long John Silver Restaurant is currently located in Lexington Park. He's also an owner in the A&W Sunoco business in Callaway. He's previously owned the Bryan's Road BP station. So he's had a lot of retail business experience. In addition, he has worked at the Hermanville convenience store, which is a liquor store, for about 6 years. He is both TAMS certified and RAST certified. And he will be one of the persons on location actually working at the store, assuming that the application is granted. Mr. Bedwall has a financial interest in the sense that he is currently an employee at the Callaway A&W location, and he's been there for about 6 years, and he will also be working at the discount liquor location if the application is granted. Give you a little background about the location. Mr. Qureshi and his business associate purchased the property about 7 years ago, 6 or 7 years ago. The business that was located there previously was a Pizza Hut. It had been there for a lot of years. Apparently their lease was up and the location was old, and the Pizza Hut didn't renew their lease. So it came on the market for sale. Mr. Qureshi bought the property, actually demolished the Pizza Hut building because it was 35, 40 years old and just obsolete. Actually, he purchased an additional lot contiguous to where the Pizza Hut had been to give a larger area for the new business that he was going to open. And then he commenced to build the building and parking lot, which is now Long John Silver. I might add this was a large expense. The investment in this property, including buying the building, buying the property, the next door property, demolishing the building, building a new building, costs about $1.6 million. He has a substantial investment in this property. He opened Long John Silver about 6 years ago. At that time, there was no McDonald's restaurant on Great Mills Road. Soon after he opened Long John Silver, McDonald's started building a restaurant basically directly across the street in St. Mary's Square. That store opened about 3 months after Mr. Qureshi's restaurant, and it was basically very devastating to the restaurants that were in the stretch with Long John Silver. There's a Long John Silver, a Wendy's, and a KFC all right there in a row, and they basically all took a very big hit when McDonald's opened across the street. The business has never recovered from that. At one time, I think when they opened the business, it was doing I can't remember exactly, but I'll tell you in a minute. $8,000 in sales per day to $3,000 per day, just right after the McDonald's opened. And currently, it's dwindled to about $700 per day. So the business has just declined, and it's just no longer viable as a restaurant. Mr. Qureshi began thinking about alternative uses for his building, and he made some inquiries. Things that came up that he thought about were Dairy Queen, Jiffy Lube, another A&W business, and maybe some others that he could tell you about. But and he made some inquiries, and basically none of the franchisees were interested in that location. As I told you, he's had some experience in the liquor store business, working at a liquor store for the last 6 years, and owning businesses that are similar. And he determined that a liquor store at that location would be a good business, would be convenient to the community. In case you're not familiar with the number of liquor stores or locations along Great Mills Road, currently, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think there's only one actual packaged goods store on the north side of Great Mills Road for the whole length of the road. There are business establishments off the road, like in Millicent Plaza and Shangri-La Drive and so forth. But on Great Mills Road, there's only one location, and that is International Beverage and Deli, which is, I'm not sure the exact location, but it's approximately a mile further towards Route 5 from the location where Mr. Qureshi wants to open his store. So he feels that there will be a great convenience to the community. People coming from the base when they get off work, this would be the first location, closest location on the north side of the northbound Great Mills Road, which is where the traffic would be coming. I know you have been presented with a petition signed by people who are in opposition to this application. My client has a petition as well, and I'm going to pass an original and five copies up so that everybody can have a copy. Let's see, which one is the original? This is the original? Okay, good. All right. And I'm going to keep one for myself. Yeah. I'd like to present this as an exhibit to be considered. Present to the chairman and pass copies around everybody. I understand there are about 800 signatures on that petition, and they all support the issuance of a license at this location.
Mr. Davis, before you proceed, typically we have a cutoff for something like this, whether it be letters or petitions such as this, and that date was what, Tammy?
Monday. Mr. Chairman, I spoke to Ms. Hildebrand, and she reminded me of the cutoff, but she said that for presenting it to the Liquor Board Secretary, there was a 72-hour cutoff, but I understood that we could introduce it here at the meeting.
Stuff like that at meetings in the past.
Okay. Well, all good. Accept it.
Okay. Thank you.
Tina, I'll give you this one.
The record.
Okay. I think that's probably all I wanted to say by way of introductory comments. I would like to now ask Mr. Qureshi a few questions if the board is ready for that.
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Kreshi, you've already stated your name and address. I understand you live in Waldorf, but you've been working in this area for a number of years. Is that right?
Yeah, 10 years.
Okay.
2006, when we got the first station, Callaway A&W Sunoco.
Okay. I'd like to just ask you a few questions that are questions you've already answered on your application, but it wouldn't hurt to just review those. You've never had a prior license for the sale of alcoholic beverages denied or revoked, have you?
No.
Okay. And let's see. Have you ever been convicted of a felony?
No.
Have you ever been adjudged guilty of violating the laws concerning the sale of alcoholic beverages?
No.
Are you financially interested in any other place of business in the county where a license is issued?
Liquor license?
Uh-huh.
No.
State whether or do you have a pecuniary interest in this business? Do you have a financial interest in this business?
Yes.
Okay. And other than Mr. Kureshi, your the other member, and Mr. Betwall, of course, is there anyone else who has a financial interest in the business to be conducted there?
No.
And if you're granted a license, do you intend to conform to the laws relating to the sale of alcoholic beverages?
Yes, of course.
Okay. And do you intend to keep all of your state tax obligations current?
Yes.
Okay. I think I've covered most everything on the license. If I've missed anything, the answers have already been signed on the application. Now, would you state what your experience is in retail sales, either at the current location or other locations in the county or elsewhere, just to give the board members an opportunity to assess your business experience?
We have multiple locations for retail businesses, which include gas stations, food services, like all the retails. I'm in a business for the last 16 years, and in San Luis County, I'm here for like 10 years. Again, I mentioned before, Callaway A&W Sunoco. I'm running it last 10 years now, and then we opened a second branch of A&W Long John Silver in a Great Mills Road 6 years ago. Only that business is struggling very hard right now. I have the financial P&L for the current business if you guys would like to see. I did make the 6-7 copies of last 3 years' P&Ls for the current business. We are doing very bad up there. My whole investment, we are keep putting money down every year, about $100,000 a year, just to run the business, to leave it open. Now we are in that position that we don't want, we cannot do that. It's getting worse and worse and worse every single day. There's multiple reasons for that. I mean, McDonald's was the first one. As soon as they opened, the same day our sale went from 8,000 to 3,000, same day. And since then, it's going down and down, and now we are doing only $700, $800 a day. We are estimating losing like at least $600, $700 per day right now, just putting the money from the pocket, from our personal money, from the other businesses. It's created a lot of tensions and in my personal life. we don't want to just close it down. Since I am the owner of the land and the building, it's better to do something that I'm probably good at it in a retail business rather than the food itself.
Okay, let me now show you a paper and ask you, is this an aerial view of the Great Mills Road area showing a dot where your business is located along that
yes.
road?
Yes, that's right.
Okay. I'd like to pass up, probably all familiar with this, but I'd like to pass it up and just give you a visual indication of where the business is located along Great Mills Road. In reference to St. Mary's Square and some of the residential areas in the neighborhood. Okay, now I'd like to get a little specific about what you propose to do at this location. First of all, can you describe the building and the parking area for me?
It's a very big parking lot because of the restaurant. It has more parking than actually needed for the liquor license. The building is approximately 2,800 square foot. It's a pretty large size of building. And it's like any other typical freestanding restaurant, like any other.
Okay. If the board grants you a license at this location, can you describe what your product line will be at that location? What do you intend to actually offer for sale?
We are actually coming for a lot of experience from the multiple businesses, not just a liquor, beer. My plan is to introduce more services other than beer, wine, and the liquor, which include money orders, bill payment. We can accept all the major utilities bill payments on that spot, and they can be credited the same day. Right now, residents has to go probably, let's say, Smeco bill. They go from there to all the way to Newlandtown just to pay a Smeco bill. We can accept it on the same location, and it can be credited to the customer or consumer account right away. Also, Metcon. Again, they have to come from around, I think they just opened in Route 4, Metcom location to accept the bill. We can accept it on the spot right there and then. It's just an example of only two biggest utilities company. We have hundreds of accounts that we can accept there, including credit cards and other stuff. Also, we are planning to do the offer a money order and the check cashing as the things gonna progress. We already doing these services in other location. So basically the gist.
If you're granted a license in connection with the actual interior of the premises, what upgrades, facilities do you plan to have within the building that you feel will be a little more convenient, more of a standout compared with other liquor stores?
The biggest thing we are planning to have there is a walk-in cage. It will be much bigger size than any other liquor store around the area has currently. Customer feel free can go theirself into the cage cooler, grab the coldest beer, and then come out very nicely. It's also have the capability to have some cold wines in it to make freshmen more enjoyable.
Okay. Would you tell the board who you think will be your customers? Who do you think, where are your customers, where are they going to come from?
I
go ahead.
I study the area, And the biggest customer we have is Protection Homes. We are right in front of the Protection Homes, and every whole management is backside of us. Then after that, we have a Green Parts apartments. The Pax River is on our right-hand side. St. Clements Crossing, Forest Road, Suburban State, and it's a name of few. Then the first liquor store, international liquor store, is going to come in. So before that, we have a lot of potential. Also, all the base customer, when they get off from the work around 3, 4 o'clock, they take that road, and we will be the first one to get most likely they get a most convenient liquor store on their way out. They don't have to do zigzag or go to the shopping center or any other, or cross the street just to buy probably one beer case or something.
Okay. What other alcoholic beverage liquor stores are there on Great Mills Road on the north side of the highway?
Actually, there's only one. It's on the international international liquor, I think. International Beverages is the first one on the north side of it. There's none other than the shopping center for 2000 Liquor. It's all the way inside, beside the big lot. It's not on Great Mills Road, it's totally separate. And so basically there's none. We will be the first one, then the International Beverage.
And how far is International Beverage further down the road from your location?
It's 1 mile, exactly 1 mile. It's pretty far if you drive by.
Okay. I think that may be all the questions I have of Mr. Qureshi at this time. Ladies and gentlemen, I can ask a few questions of Mr. Bedwall.
Okay.
Mr. Bedwall, you've already stated your address as being in Callaway. How long have you lived there?
6 years.
Okay. And you are currently employed at the A&W Sunoco, is that right?
That's correct.
And how long have you been working there?
6 years.
All right. You have been authorized and you are willing to be a licensee at this location, are you not?
Yes.
Okay. And have you ever been, if you are a, if the license is granted and you work there, you would have a financial interest, you get paid for your working there, would you not?
Yes.
Okay. And have you ever had a sale of alcoholic, a license for the sale of alcoholic beverages denied or revoked?
No.
Okay. Have you ever been convicted of a felony?
No.
Have you ever been adjudged guilty of violating the laws governing the sale of alcoholic beverages?
No.
Are you financially interested in any other place of business in the county where there's a liquor license?
No.
You already stated you'll have a pecuniary interest by virtue of your employment. Do you know of any other persons interested in this business other than Mr. Qureshi and his partner?
Other than?
Yeah.
No.
If this license is granted and you're working there, do you intend to become familiar with the alcoholic beverages laws by attending the TAMS and RAS programs?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I think that's all the questions I have of Mr. Bedwall. I think that's probably all I have. If you board members have any questions, open it up for that.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Davis. Mr. Qureshi, I understand it's a again, we've talked about a business decision for something else. You know, someone had basically surrendered voluntarily the license and they came back and said asked it to kind of help their business along. This one is that because of that, this premise is currently a Long John Silver's restaurant. So you're saying it's basically failing.
That's right, badly.
So your business plan is to convert it to a liquor store to help you recoup your money invested in that property, correct?
That's right.
Okay.
Especially the daily expenses, at least, you know, to get going.
Yeah. And it's more of a comment for my part, is that I'm sympathetic with your, you know, the business situation you're in, but the understanding that this board is deals with administration of Article 2B and our local rules and regs on alcohol licensing and basically the care and feeding of those licenses, you know, with a licensee. One of the things that in the introduction of today's meeting, I talked about 10202. Mr. Davis is very familiar with that. And some of those things, hopefully he's reviewed these with you. And if not, then, Mr. Davis, you have a
2B? I don't have the statute with me, Your Honor. Mr. Chairman.
Here you go. You can share that with him. And then, but basically, it's kind of a guide. It allows the board to, you know, some of the criteria. Basically, one of the things that really jumps out is the first one. I mean, and I don't think that this was, when they made this law, that there was any, splitting any hairs about what should be the top one. And the first one is the public need and desire for the license. In the application process, you know, you took the application and you got this required signatures so we can bring your license forward into the meeting, correct?
That's right.
Okay, so how many license or how many signatures did you get on your license application?
We got 34 initially, and I think 10 or 15 got approved that fulfilled the criteria for the liquor board.
Right, because again, they have to be property owners
for
the signatures, right? So, but you resolved all those issues, and that was good. So we appreciate that. And one of the things that Mr. Davis presented this, basically, what is a counter petition to the, because you knew before this meeting that there was a petition that had been circulated, and I think what was the final count, Tammy?
206
signatures. One of the reasons why we'd like to have it in advance is so we can kind of review, I don't want to say the credibility, but the application of this petition to the situation that we're being, you know, considering today. One of the things, the very first signature I have is a Lusby, Maryland resident. Not even this county, you know, it's not on Great Mills Road.
They are using the Great Mills Road coming from it.
From Lusby?
No, from the base to there. Maybe the person was going somewhere, but they do use Great Mills Road as a primary.
To go home to Lusby? I don't think so.
But the person was there initially when they come in a Long John Silver, we offer them.
Okay, I understand. But you yourself, you live in Waldorf. You live in a development?
Yes, Dorchester.
Okay. How many liquor stores are near your development?
None. Very far.
Okay. Because you haven't had the benefit of, I've been on the board now for 7 years, I believe. It's been a while, so I've been doing this a long time. We've heard a lot of situations about the activity on Great Mills Road. Okay, in some cases, I'm going to look to our alcohol enforcement coordinator, but there's a lot of issues with violations with open containers.
Since August 19th, 2013 to
December 31st of 2014, the end of the new year. On Great Mills Road alone, there was 113 alcohol criminal citations for people consuming in public off Great Mills Road or in the grassy areas behind businesses and stuff. The cops unit's done a good job of trying to curb consumption in public, but it's still a concern that there's addressing with bike patrol, foot patrol, just through the everyday responsibilities of doing enforcement for the better quality of life in Lexington Park. And but 113 citations, that's more than underage drinking citations we do in several years. And that's just literally within a year time frame, 113 citations. So it is a big issue.
Okay. And the other thing that, because we know, obviously, because we administer the licenses, we know how many licenses are approved and are actually in use right now on Great Mills Road. So I think this is, Mr. Davis, you can have one of these. But this is basically kind of in your pictorial that you had given, you know, that Mr. Davis had presented. But this kind of lays out all the licenses there on Great Mills Road for you. So you kind of have a better visual understanding of where I'm coming from and my questioning. So, but
on the diagram that the chairman just issued you, there's dots on the map. On the map where there's a purple dot is the location of where your business currently stands, the purple dot on the map. And as you previously said, Mr. Davis was the only one that's on the north side of Great Mills Road is the Cadillac Jack's International Beverage. But 2000 Liquors is also on that side and Millicent Plaza. As well as directly across the street, less than 75 yards is County Liquors, and maybe 100 yards is Canopy Liquors, which is, you can see both locations from the curb of the parking lot of the location you guys are suggesting.
And I don't disagree with that, ladies and gentlemen, but I do reiterate that this is those places, other places are on the opposite side of Great Mills mm-hmm. Road, not the north side. 2000 Liquors is close, but it's, you know, a block or so off the road. I'm not even sure whether International Beverage is on here. Is that it?
Yeah. Just okay. South.
All right.
So again, I'm just kind of trying to.
We agree there are other locations, but we think that the things that we've said make this unique to a certain extent.
I understand.
Which is one of your criteria, and I think we've certainly demonstrated that it would be convenient. I mean, we've got a petition signed by 800 people, and they. Just coincidentally, maybe the first one lives in Lusby, but apparently he works in Lexington Park, and you know.
Mr. Davis, there are also beverages. A number of them that don't even have addresses, so we don't know where they
are. Well, I apologize for that.
If you give the addresses for some reason, you know, their personal information when I asked them personally.
Mm-hmm.
And on the petition that was filed against us, it's the same thing. I mean, I mark and red mark all the addresses. The street is not, I don't know where these streets are in that area.
Right.
And when I Google it, and a couple of places are, they just write Lexington Park. Same thing, I mean, customers don't like it, but it doesn't mean they're not using the area,
mm-hmm.
or crossing by or do some kind of business or their daily
right. places. Understand, and that's fair, and it's one of the things that, because again, you know, you were provided a copy of this petition that was presented to the board, and we received it on the 5th of January, and it's in our records. So, but just again, just going down this
I call it a checklist, okay, in Article 2B. The second thing is that the number and location of existing licenses and potential effect on the existing licensees of the license applied for. The potential commonality or uniqueness of the services and products to be offered by the applicant's business, which you say there's some benefits. You know, you're talking about the very large walk-in cage and some of those things. The fourth one is the impact on the general health, safety, and welfare of the community. Okay. And then that's including issues relating to crime, traffic conditions, parking, or convenience. And then it says any other factors as determined by the board, which is a lot of laws. They said, you know, whatever we think is. And that's where some of these issues that may or may not be addressed in our local rules and regs. So that's kind of really to wrap it up. That's about all we really have to, some of the initial criteria. I mean, that's something, since I've been on the board, we've always, for me, I look at that as questions are being asked, and a lot of things are answered in your application and some of the testimony that you provided and Mr. Davis's questions. But I think what we have in front of us is that without even asking the audience, I know that there is a petition against this application. And in addition to, I believe, electronically, we have a...
We had three letters, one letter and one email in opposition.
Okay.
And received by the deadline.
And then that one email is from a county commissioner. Okay. So were you aware of that, Mr. Davis?
I was, and if I recall correctly, I don't have a copy with me, but I don't think he said he was opposed to it, but just couldn't support it.
It reads, please note my opposition to the proposed liquor store on Great Mills Road at the A&W site.
Okay.
So it's, you know, that's...
It's an email from Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, Commissioner Morgan.
And not on County Commissioner letterhead. I'm submitting to you that he's sent that email as a citizen and not as a representative of the board. If he just, the Board of County Commissioners, if he was doing that, I think it would be on official letterhead and say so. But so I think his opposition shouldn't carry any more weight than any other citizen, frankly.
Okay. But again, I want to put this out there to let you know what's currently, at least in my thought process here as we go through this. One of the things that the board members themselves were divided, except for I'm a member at large, so I kind of have the luxury to be, you know, all throughout the county have a major consideration about what goes on in the county. Some of the things we did that cooperation with the Retail Beverage Association, you know, they came up with this quota type system based on census, you know, allowed Class A licenses, which you're applying for, per district. And I think there's how many?
27 allowed in District 8, and we have 20 current.
So we have 20 current. So there's 7 licenses to be, you know, authorized, you know, that we would, you know, actually put out. One of the things that you heard earlier today that, for example, Ridge, you know, there's very little business down there as far as in the way of alcohol sales and things like that. So that's one of the things. And that's good, you know, to put something like that down in the southern part of the county. But the member that represents this area that you're proposing, you know, you've asked us to approve this application. That's your area. So it's the vice chair. So the vice chair is comes from that district. She lives in that area, so that's one of the things that. So,
Mr. Chairman, just if I may comment on your last comment about the quota system and that is based on the census and so forth. I've looked at the comprehensive plan put out by one of the county agencies. And first of all, note that District 8 represents 36% of the population of the whole county. So it's the largest election district in the county. Mm-hmm. And it has the earliest census figure I see on this this document is 2009, and it said that the population in the 8th election district was 34,917. And then as of July 1st, 2013, which is 4 years later, it's jumped to 37,166. And the projection for 2015 is 38,612. So I'm not sure when the last license was issued for a liquor store along there. But I just point out that the census, the population has grown in that area. And I think that's one of the other factors to consider in, you know, the need for a store. And since I have a few copies of this, I'll just pass it up in case it's of interest to the board members.
Okay. It's the same one.
It's the same one you use.
Mm-hmm. Oh, maybe you already have it. Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay. But again, here, just to be fair, because again, that's one of my tenets for being the chair, is just, you know, fair and reasonable administration of Article 2B in our local rules and regs. I just want to let you know this is kind of the thing that we have to consider when looking at your application. So, any other questions for me?
Anybody else have anything?
So, Tammy, let me ask you, is this a conditional, which
yes.
It's going to be?
It was a conditional approval, yes. I mean, it was a conditional request.
Of course.
So, yeah, we were looking at 90 days.
Yeah, and this 90 days because there's an existing premise. So, basically, you would have to do a tear out of the building and do what you want to do with all the, and because Garland hasn't been there, obviously, because it's not a, it's a restaurant, so there's nothing that, so again, a conditional, as far as everything else that they've.
Is the A&W part going to be torn down also, or just along John Silver?
Both.
Both?
Yes. It used to be the same company when we opened it. Since the Long John Silver and A&W split last couple of past years, it's creating a problem to do the business in one location, two different branches. It used to be one company.
Right.
Like 3 years ago, 5 years ago.
Yeah. So what your plan is to convert the entire premise into discount liquors.
Everything.
I think that's to answer your question. Yeah. Okay.
You've been asking.
But the TAM certification, that's still outstanding, I think.
Yeah, no, Mr. Qureshi has TAM certification. Okay. And he has been to rest.
Okay. So the things that are outstanding would be the UNO.
Yep.
Which would be fire marshal, health.
Yeah, once he got some remodels here.
Right. Trader's license. So, again, it's just a. So it wouldn't be, if it was approved, it wouldn't be approved today anyway because you have some work to do.
Yes, it's going to take time.
More than likely 90 days.
Yeah, probably.
90 days was the max.
Right, 90 days is max because again, it's not new building involved. I mean, you're kind of remodeling the current. Right.
It might be done within 90 days, but we have to see, you know, how things.
Right, and so
if that were a limitation placed on the board, would you make it happen within 90 days?
Yes, that's going to be the first priority.
But it's one of the things. What I'm saying is that if you don't get it done within 90 days, you'd have to come back in, and then the conditional period would be extended some period of time.
Usually the county office, you know, the permitting department can require us to do certain things which we have to do it, depending on that, what their comments are.
Right.
Right now we're talking to the civil engineer who already designed the plan, how it's going to go. then we're going to wait for the approval from the county.
So your plan that you have is what you currently have in the sketch you provided?
Yes, that's the same plan he's working on. You know.
Okay. Garland, have you seen this? Have you seen their plan, the cooler and...
Your cooler is going to be in the far back of the building.
That's right.
The walk-in cooler, yeah.
Big cage. The big cage is going to be all the way back off the side of the building.
And you have another storage area inside there, another cooling?
Yeah, walk-in cooler.
Walk-in cooler, right.
In front of the building.
And what's these three areas here on the right-hand side? I can see, is that?
Freezers and coolers.
That's the storage.
Yes,
the storage is to the right of your building's going to be right. Cooler, the outside.
Cooler, freezer.
Yeah, it's going to within everything going to be within the building. No external wall going to be tear up, nothing at all. Everything within the current approved process. So the process is going to go faster by the county.
And you've submitted this to planning and zoning already?
Not yet. We are waiting for to see if any change is going to come or 99% that's the plan for it to be.
Right. So there's a possibility this could change if you, because the county would require, because of some code.
Any code that, you know, we are not fulfilling on this drawing, we will do that.
Okay. All right. So again, I just want to advise you that it wouldn't be approved today. It would be conditional until you meet the use and occupancy requirements. You know, that's fire marshal. That's all the things, and get a final blessing, as it was from the county land use and growth management. Okay. Anything else? Any comments, your enforcement coordinator?
Just the information I stated prior to about the location, the places that are nearby, and also behind this location that they're at is 84 Lumber, right? 84 Lumber, and it's a wooded area behind there that leads to Patuxent Homes. Patuxent Homes adjacent behind there, correct?
Yes.
So, in my mind, it's just going to make it a little bit more complicated to enforce some of the people drinking in public, because there's a lot more wooded area and stuff for people to hang out by fence lines and stuff.
Well, I believe they have a fence already back there.
There's a fence, a gate, but it leads back, and there's
But Wendy's also have a fence.
Wendy's has a fence as well.
Yeah,
but it leads back to the 84 Lumber, and it's wide open back there, though, correct?
Go back. I believe there's a fence. Wendy's has the full fence to block the whole wooded area, and the 84 Lumber has the fence to their side of the property.
Okay. So just the cops unit's done a great job of enforcing, trying to the quality of life, working with the Lexington Park community, Robin Finicon, and members of that group that's done a good job of revitalizing the businesses of Lexington Park. And through my experience, putting another one in the area is just giving even more access to alcohol that's already saturated in that small area. I mean, if it takes me to sprint from that store to the other store, I can be there in 20 seconds on a full sprint run. And I could be to Canopy Liquor in maybe 30 seconds to 45 seconds on a full sprint run. I just think, you know, in my opinion, as law enforcement, is too close together. And there's really, is there a necessity for it in that area? No, it's already saturated in that general area. If it's wider part through Great Mills Road, then possibly you could argue that point, but where it's at, the distance between the two other liquor stores, just.
I think they already start dividing the Great Mills Road. If you see beginning of Great Mills Road where the second gate is, they already divide the whole stretch of it all the way to Atishangaya land and further. I think by the tire place, the road is already divided. There's a path in the middle.
It's
pretty stretchful out of that.
It's two-lane roadway, east and west on Great Mills Road, both ways. And even through there, there's been pedestrians struck through that area over the years, and some of the pedestrian strikes have been because of people intoxicated, where fatalities have happened. Again, I'm just giving statistics. I'm giving knowledge of experience, giving locations, and 113 citations for open containers within that area. If I pulled the stats for alcohol citations for underage, in probably 5 or 6 years, maybe 7 years, I'd have to combine all this to get to that statistic. So that's just a lot of citations.
Yeah. And we're kind of, I think you get the understanding about.
I didn't.
Okay. But what I'd like to do is just, because you're aware of not only the petition, but there's the email from the county commissioner. Whether or not it's on letterhead, I choose to accept it as valuable to this determination of, the outcome of this application. He is a county commissioner. So, and then I have the a letter here also. Mr. Davis, have you seen this letter?
I have seen that.
Okay. So it's signed, and it's one of the things that we have a requirement that if someone wants to petition, a grievance, against this application, that they either present it with, their contact information and such, and it's been done. So what I'd like to do is just go ahead and entertain from the audience anyone that has any testimony they'd like to provide for our consideration in this application. And hopefully you've signed up, so we have your okay. So one at a time, please. If you come to the mic and we'd get you sworn in, get your name and address for the record.
Yes, my name is Willie Lennon.
Raise your right hand, please, sir. Do you hereby declare and affirm that the testimony you're about to give to be the truth and nothing but the truth?
Absolutely. Yes.
Name and address for the record, please.
My name is Willie Lennon. I'm from Lexington Park, Maryland. There's already 7 liquor stores on Great Mills Road in Lexington Park, 2 mile radius, 7. If you're going to add one more, you might want to add a school, a church, something for the kids. You have nothing there already. If you're going to do anything, put something down for the kids. We all looking for it. Mm-hmm. You put another liquor store, all you're doing is building up for them. You say, don't drink and drive. Don't ride the bicycle and drive. Give them something to look forward to, not another liquor store. Thank you.
Before you leave, sir, where do you live? Do you live on Great Mills Road or right off Great Mills Road?
Right now I live in Joe Baker.
Which is?
Joe Baker Court. That's behind McKay's, mm-hmm. Senior Citizens Outlet. Mm-hmm. We had a liquor store at McKay's, okay? The store gone. I don't mind walking to 2,000 Liquors, Don's, the Canopy. I don't mind walking all the way to Sheik's. I don't. It's exercise for me. But to cross over to that side, just to go get liquor, and you talking about the base traffic coming up. Do you know what it is at 3:30 and 4:30 in the afternoon, trying to get out of one of those outlets without a light? Impossible. And you talking about putting another liquor store there? You just adding it to the crime.
Okay,
that's all.
All right. Before you leave, Mr. Davis, do you have anything or?
I have no questions, Your Honor. Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Gresh, do you have any questions?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
You know, opinion, you know, my case got closed. That was one of the reasons we thought maybe can have one. Since the case is gone now.
Mm-hmm. Understand. Anyone else?
Raise your right hand, sir. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you are about to give is the truth and nothing but the truth?
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
Again, name and address for the record, please.
Francis J. Hicks Wright, and I live at 46158 Radford Lane, Patuxent Court, right? That's right behind the McKay's, too, right? And first and foremost, I want to thank the board for allowing me to say what I have to say. I want to make it perfectly clear that I don't have anything against the person or persons who's applying for this liquor license and stuff, right? And I want him to know that, I want them to know that it sounds as though that he done did a lot of good things for the community and stuff, right? And I'm sorry about, you know, the McDonald's coming up and the Long John Silver's not doing it so well because of that and things of that nature. But we all know that, that's just business life, right? And if he was promoting anything else, I would most certainly support him. But I'm strongly against this another liquor store open up, right? You know, citations that the sheriff, you know, just gave. I know he's correct, right? But I was thinking that it was at least 300 or 400 because they drinking out in the public all day long, you know, with these open containers and stuff. And we as residents, we can't even get out our vehicles to attend nothing, not even the gas stations, without people bombarding us, asking for money and things of that nature, right? Now, I know that he got this petition and it's signed by all of these people, but I know that most majority of these people do not live on Great Meals, and therefore they don't see the riffraff and the bums and stuff that, and the crime and stuff that be taking places, that taking place from all these liquor stores being here. So I strongly suggest that the board, you know, not today, not tomorrow, not ever open up another liquor store. And thank God that McKay's closed up as far as the liquor store. Thank you.
Thank you.
Real quick before you go away, sir. So, again, you live in the Great Mills community,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
Right,
yes,
off the
I
Great
do.
Mills Road. Okay.
Yes, I want to commend the sheriff for the information that you gave. That was very nice of you.
All right. And Mr. Davis or Ms. Kresh, do you have any questions?
Do you have any questions, Mr. Kresh?
No question, just a comment. McKay's is like a mile and a half further from the location. I don't know how it's affecting the location. Plus those petition that he mentioned, that everybody is living on that strip or crossing that. That's why we got the petition. Like 800 application, you know, for people who are living or passing through that road at that day.
You're talking about your application was signed by people that
your petition,
are property owners in
the petition or the application?
Or the application.
Yeah, for 800 signatures, they are living or using that road. It's not like
living or using on that
using
road. Okay,
well,
gotcha.
Yes. Well, if I may say this right, but these are people that's using the Great Mills exit or whatever, right? And even him himself say he do not reside here, that he live in Waldorf, right? So he's not there to see the riffraff that's being caused by all of these liquor stores and stuff, right? You know, and if he was living there, I'm pretty sure he would change his mind today about trying to attempt to open up another liquor store. Thank you.
Okay. Any other questions?
No.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
We'll get you sworn in and.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby affirm and declare by the penalties of perjury the testimony you're about to give to be the truth and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
Name and address for the record, please, sir.
Yeah, my name is Willie Kraft. I live in Hughesville, Maryland, 6970 Woodburn Drive. But we have a business here. We had a property, commercial property right on Great Mills Road, 21632 Great Mills Road. I want to recommend thank you all the sheriff department for helping me, for helping us. They're one of the finest police force in the counties that I see as I go around.
We bought this place over a year ago. I hear them talking about the money that they lost. We losing $270,000. We hard to sell it because of alcohol and drugs. I've been going at it with these people for over a decade. In the sheriff's department, they've been very fine in helping me. And I appreciate that. They call me. We're trying to sell the property now. It's still hard because people ride by and say, folks hang around drunk, with beer cans and stuff, in that Great Mills Road area. And to me, it's more than enough liquor stores there. And the agency been trying to sell it and can't sell it. I heard he talking about he lost money. We lost our retirement there. What are we going to do? And to me, it's more than enough. And I heard this gentleman talking about he lived there. I understand because I know what they're going through. Thank God I don't live there. But I know what I've been through, arguing. They have seen me out there at night, arguing with people. Haven't been cussed out?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Cussed out, called the sheriff. I got a stack of no trespassing like this. And the sheriff department, one of the finest forces here. And they still watching out the building for me. People ride by, so no, we can't buy it. That's all I want to say. Anybody got any questions, ask me. Me and my wife are losers.
And again, just to clarify, so you do not live...
Now, I do not live there, but since we had the property, I almost lived there at night, coming down there at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning.
Right. So, that's again, that's one of the things that, for you, it's...
And getting cussed out and threatened. Oh, I had many threats.
Yeah.
And people drunk, they're threatening your heart. And these officers, they know. am I telling a lie?
Yeah. But, so you think that this deserves a peace and the safety of the...
Sure. As the gentleman said, it should be churches or something else,
Okay.
Or whatever. But, I'm just saying, we cannot recoup.
Mr. Kraft, you gave the location of the property you own in Great Mill on Great Mills Road, but what kind of business is it?
This was some stores and apartments. It was a mixed unit, apartments and a couple of stores.
Where is it with reference to?
This is located with the laundromat and next door to Camden Liquor Store. And this is, right across from the rescue squad. And that whole strip, one owned about, I guess it meant about 4 years ago, who had bought Lowe's Lodge, he lost that. And because of the activities around there. And, we about in the Verge. So, it's rough.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I have anything else? Anyone else from the audience? Okay, and again, just because I stated it's on the record, and Mr. Davis, you've seen this petition as well, so. And Ms. Quesci, and you've had the opportunity to look through that, and you made your comments about whether or not they were actual residents that lived off of the Great Mills Road community. Okay. Any other questions for the applicants?
No. Can I just make a comment?
Let's wait till we get a motion to see what we're going to do on the action for whether or not to approve it or not.
I didn't know where that gentleman was from. That's what I was asking. The last gentleman. Was he from?
No, I believe Hughesville.
Hughesville, okay.
Yeah, he lives in Hughesville. So he's just making a comment.
He's from
Hughesville.
He was a business owner and then.
And he still owns it, he says.
He still owns it? Uh-huh. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm spitting right now.
Okay. All right. So if there's. So what we're looking at is this would be a conditional, if approved, 90 days maximum allowed, pending UNO, traders.
Yeah, health, fire, he needs a permit, occupancy, traders, yeah.
Fire. All right. Nothing else?
Mr. Chairman, can I ask you one question? I just want to know what his intentions are.
Ron Silver and the WEW into a business.
Yes, that's correct. So the whole premise changes from what it is as a restaurant to a liquor store. Sir. Okay. So if there's no further questions, I'd like to do is entertain a motion from the board for action on the discount liquors requests.
All right. I will make a motion. Make a motion that we deny the application of Wakar A. Qureshi and Sashadar Vitwal to purchase a Class A1 Beer Wine Liquor License and trade as Discount Liquors, LLC, 21591 Great Mills Road, Lexington Park, Maryland, 20653. Due to the lack of public need and desire for the license, the number and location of existing licensees in the proposed license area, and the potential negative impact on the general health, safety, and welfare of the community.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second from Member Hall. Okay. Now we can discuss this. Your comment? You had a comment?
No, my comment was where the gentleman was from. That's what I was trying to think.
And then as far as the...
My only comment is that I too travel the Great Mills Corridor every day, three times a day, and my business is in Lexington Park. And the need for a liquor store is not what we need in Lexington Park anymore. We've done enough to clean it up. It's running a little bit better now. But nine liquor stores, even though there's two north, there's six going south. And we do not need another liquor store in Lexington Park. That's my only comment.
Anything else?
And I'll comment. I mean, even though I made the motion, I do sympathize for, you know, the issue that you're going through. I mean, hopefully you can find, you know, and once again, the motion still has to pass, but hopefully, you know, if the motion does pass, you can find another way to, you know, to change the business with, you know, besides that. But I just believe that that's something in that area, and I'm born and raised here, and I know that area, and it's, in my opinion, not something that is needed from the community. So,
anything else?
No, that pretty much says it all. I mean, with the amount of liquor stores there, there's not really another one needed. And,
yeah. And for me, for Member Mathis, if he wouldn't have made that motion, I would have done it. Again, I think one of the primary things, as he chose, was the about the peace and the safety of the residents. If there's something, we would be doing injustices to the county if we added another Class A license on that road. That's my opinion. Okay, I'm one of five. Okay. So, with that, there's nothing else. Okay. I'd like to entertain a vote from the board. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. Sir, your application has been denied. And you have a right to appeal this to the Circuit Court of St. Mary's County within 30 days.
Thank you for your consideration.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Davis.
Thank you, Mr. Davis.
Tammy, you need this one, right? Okay. Are we good? Okay, we're good. Let's continue the agenda, the premise changes. I have Choptico Market, Ronald and Gwendolyn Tennyson, request an extension of main premise by approximately 1,500 square feet for new kitchen area and upper level storage.
Right hand, please. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you're about to give is the truth and nothing but the truth?
Yes.
Thank you. Have a seat.
And I do have a letter from Mr. Tennyson giving Mrs. Tennyson permission to speak on his behalf.
Okay. Very good. So name and address for the record, please, ma'am.
24346 Maddox Road, Choptico, Maryland. 20621.
And your name?
Gwen Tennyson.
And as Tammy said, we have the authorization from the licensee for the that's not present today, so she can speak on his behalf. Okay, so I always blame Garland for these things, but. So you're looking for a new addition.
There is an addition. We have an addition. I did not know that I was supposed to contact the board because there's no alcohol in it. So, but he made sure I knew that I was wrong.
As I said, you're looking for a new addition. So normally you would get the approval before you add, and then you would. Before, but
I know that now.
The new addition is there.
Yes.
Right. So you're just looking to make Garland happy. So
yes.
Okay. All right. So basically, your extended premise is for this drawing.
Yes.
And that's it, right?
Yep.
And so you're not for this new addition. Is it going to be? It's just for. It's not for
fryers,
alcohol storage.
Booth so my employees can have somewhere to sit to eat, storage upstairs, just a work area. It's a very small work area for my employees.
Okay.
And I'm hoping in the spring I can open up ice cream for the public.
Okay. I knew he had something to do with it. So, Tammy, that's just...
Everything, she had all the approvals, everything's good.
Everything's good?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Anything else? Any other questions? Okay. Nothing else, and I'd like to entertain a motion from the board for action on Choptico's Market request for the extension of the premise.
I make a motion. We approved a request for extension of premise for Choptico Market, Ronald and Gwendolyn Tennyson.
Approximately 1,500 square feet for a new kitchen area and upper level storage.
I have a motion. I have a second.
Second.
Second from Member Curry. Again, I think we've covered this one. It's Garland's fault. all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carries. Good luck.
All right. Thank you so much.
Good luck on your ice cream and endeavor.
Sure, yeah.
A little cold for us today.
Yes.
Drew me in. Yeah.
Okay. Next, I have Stoney's at Clark's Landing. Cousin O, Lewis Phillips Stone III and Catherine Bailey York. Correcting the original application submission to include two standalone walk-in boxes for food and beer.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby declare and affirm under the penalties of perjury that the testimony you are about to give will be the truth and nothing but the truth?
Yes.
I do.
Thank you.
And I do have a letter on file that Mr. Stone can speak on this Jeannie Cosino's behalf.
I would prefer to do the speaking, but that's okay. I think everyone would prefer me to do the speaking. We are just also correcting to appease Mr. Garland Thompson, the existing walk-ins, where we already have them, we're just asking permission to use them. I am to understand that they may have been left off the original plat that we submitted, and that would be just oversight in thinking that something that was existing that we just replaced would be able to be used. So we've submitted those. I have extra copies. We're just asking that we are to be able to use them.
Was it your box? Was that already there that you put that there afterwards, right?
We
took the old box down, and it's in the exact same spot. Been there for 50-some years.
You still got it right there?
But
right?
The old box is in the dumpster, and the new box is where it was. Exact same size, everything.
You just did all that?
Yeah.
Good.
Okay. Again, typically when we have these, it's because of something that he did.
There you go.
But we want to follow the rules.
You need to reprimand.
Well, like I said, and it's one of the things that, you know, and you've heard
let's
me.
Do all this
yeah,
today.
Yeah. You've heard me say, yeah.
I got to bring it to him.
We'll take care of it. Okay. Pretty simple. So just
everything.
Addendum to the drawings that were originally submitted, and that's it. Okay.
Just remember to keep them locked.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Otherwise, somebody else may be there. Okay. So with that being said, if there's no further questions, okay, I'd like to entertain a motion for action on Stoney's at Clark's Landing request for the correction of the original application, the extended premise, I guess it would be.
I'll make a motion that we approve Stoney at Clark's Landing's request to correct the original application submission to include two standalone walk-in boxes for food and beer.
I second.
Motion and second from the vice chair. All right. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thanks for keeping Garland happy.
Two standalone walk-in boxes for food and beer.
Okay.
Debate.
No,
I just know her. I didn't know.
Two
standalone
boxes. He said he just knocked down one and put it in the dumpster.
I think it's food and beer.
Original two, but he knocked one down. So is that just one?
No, it's two. It's two.
He's got a brand new one in the exact same spot, the exact same size.
Right. So there's the walk in for food and the one for beer, and that's the two for food and beer. Yeah.
It's two.
Yeah, and he said he threw the old one out. Yes, the food.
It's been approved. okay, next, I got officer member trade name changes. Again, these are administrative in nature, so for Peg Roachell, it's deleting Joseph Ashworth. I'd like to entertain a motion for action on that.
So moved.
Okay, do I have a second?
Yes.
A second from Member Curry. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. That's been approved. Ruby Tuesday, deleting David A. Pronounce that.
Swarto.
Mm-hmm. And David Strong, adding Donald C. Growl.
Growl.
And Edward J. Gillis.
So move.
A second.
Motion from Member Hall and second by the Vice Chair. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Okay, moving right along into other business, the board administrator.
You received copies of your budget. Nothing's changed. I'm a cheap date. The only thing is I'm moving just $50 from the convention account to our membership account for Maylet because the dues went up $50, the annual dues went up $50. So it's actually not even coming out of the same category. It stays in the same category of expenditures. So nothing changes on the lines except for that. And as usual, any increase would be due to health insurance increases, COLAs, or anything that was approved by the county commissioners when they do their budget changes.
Okay. And then the grant money?
The grant money, proposal for next year's grant, it falls on a different calendar. Personally, I don't need any more money for the grant. I'm good. So I won't be changing it this year. And usually it just kind of, the change just kind of comes to me. They just kind of throw money at me, so, which is nice of them, but I'm just not able to utilize it. Like I said, I'm a cheap date. I don't, you know.
Again, what's the...
On the reclassifications, is that what you were going to ask? I have heard nothing. The new county commissioners really have just stepped on board, so I'm hoping, you know, January 1, so I'm hoping that they will start discussing that soon, and we'll get kind of a heads up from HR as to where we're going with that, if we're going anywhere.
Yeah, I looked at, what was a COLA percentage-wise?
Oh, it changes every year. Do you remember what it was, COLA? You get the same COLA. What was it, 1.5?
2.5.
Was it 2.5?
I don't know.
No.
I'm hoping. I think it's 2.
I don't know. By the time they take taxes out.
That's all I care about.
$2 million left over. We should get a lot more than that.
Yes, but we had money for snow removal. Thank God.
Yes.
And hopefully we won't need it this year.
But again, it's one of the things that I just, my position, I think Tammy needs to.
Thank you.
More money. But, and Susie and Garland for the things they do. You know, it causes trouble. And our enforcement coordinator, but I think that since he's been with us, he's been promoted. At least.
Right. Committed with what, my rank? Yeah.
Yeah.
With the corporal, but now everything has to be tested to get higher, so.
You're stuck.
I'm pretty much stuck for the time being, yeah.
So, I said, it's one of the things I just think that, you know, there has to be some type of incentive to continue to do good work. You know, I think we've kind of reached this plateau right now. We've done a lot of great stuff. I mean, the rests and things that these individuals have done, you know, basically on our behalf as board members, it's been, you know, I don't know. It's kind of like I'm tooting their horn for them, but, you know, we get the credit, this board as an entire. So I just appreciate all the work. So this budget, I would just wish it would just come in, but I ask for these pay increases. That'd be great, but it's not me. I can't do that. So maybe I can work that this year. All right, so as it sits, are there any questions about the budget? Okay, so what I'd like to do is just entertain a motion for approval of the budget as prepared by Tammy, and we've reviewed it, and we'll approve it. I'll sign it. So motion for approval of the budget for the fiscal year 2016.
Make a motion that we approve the budget for fiscal year 2016, the Alcohol Beverage Board of St. Mary's County.
Okay. Have a second?
Second.
Second from the Vice Chair. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Opposed? Okay. This is our budget.
And the only other thing I did want to just give a heads up to all the licensees that the renewal packages are going out tomorrow in tomorrow's mail. Please don't wait till the last minute to send them out, especially if you need your landlord's signature. They have to be back in the office between February 1 and March 3rd. After March 3rd, we cannot accept them, and the license that they have will expire, and they will have to come before the board and reapply for a whole new license. So please be on the lookout. If you don't get it within the next 2 weeks, call the office.
Okay. So in other words, what she's trying to say is that she's about ready to get real busy again. And it's nice to have Susie around.
Yep.
Okay. Alcohol enforcement coordinator?
In the month of December was a short month. At least for me, it has been. I didn't get a chance to prepare my monthly report yet because I was out this whole week with the flu, and today is my first day back. So I don't have a lot of statistics other than what I gathered today for the hearing to assist you guys and your decisions, which you guys made. Other than that, looking forward to 2015, so just another year, right? Moving along.
Yeah.
But Nat, and I would want to say thanks for pointing out the whole RAS and stuff. And Tammy, it didn't just start with Tammy. It started with Tommy Thompson before. It started, with multiple people being involved. And it really is useful to the community. And it means a lot that the board appreciates it. And the businesses do as well. And Tammy does an amazing job scheduling it, advertising for it, getting people to confirm the classes and material. And I do very little when it comes to all that. I just show up there and talk. But her and Garland both. Garland picks up the food and drinks and materials, study materials, and it's everybody works really well together, and it's an amazing group you guys have. So that's it. Thanks.
He does good stand-up. Don't let him fool you.
Oh. Truly.
But, again, I appreciate the comments and the input for this.
Yes, sir.
During the applications that we've heard today. That's one of the things, I think, about being prepared for the meeting. Obviously, this was not coordinated, where a lot of people, it's just facts, and facts kind of stand on their own.
Yeah. Right?
So it's one of the things that's why we have alcohol enforcement coordinator. So if we didn't have that, we wouldn't have those type of enlightening
sure.
facts mm-hmm. for, even one of the residents down on Great Mills Road was kind of surprised about it. But he, from his perspective, like you said, it was like 300. Why did they probably can write 300, but
right.
that's 113 or, 100 plus is all they could get, because otherwise that's all they'd be doing is writing citations.
Right.
So, but again, good job. We appreciate it. And yeah, looking forward to this being a good year. All right, board inspector.
Okay, for the month of December, I inspected 11 establishments and did 3 follow-up inspections. I provided an inspector letter with renewals that we sent out to all the licensees. I've provided monthly mileage reports and other reports. I provided the holiday responsible CAC drinking posters to some of the licensed establishments. I also attended and successfully completed the defensive driving course that was more or less the county wanted the drivers to do, who drove a lot during the day. And that was done by the local government insurance trust, LGIT. And I attended also the Alcohol License Association meeting for the month of December.
And obviously, he's the fruits of his labor we saw because of the some of the things that we had to around the agenda today. Great, appreciate it. Thank you, Gordon. All right, St. Mary's Licensed Beverage Association.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
David Dunn on behalf of St. Mary's County Licensed Beverage Association. We actually haven't had our meeting yet this month. We had to postpone it till next Tuesday. I don't really have anything to report from our meeting. It'll be at the ABC Liquor and Lounge next Tuesday at 2:00. The only other thing of interest is naturally the legislative session is beginning to start up again. It'll be, I think it's the second or third Wednesday in January. I think it's the 14th.
I think it's the 14th is when it.
Right. And it'll be interesting this year. We have a new slate of representatives. Delegate Tony O'Donnell is still there. And we have some new a new senator and a new delegate. So we're looking forward to working with them. From the association's point of view, just the issues that we've always been working on, we expect something probably on recycling, something on dram shop, multiple liquor license for the same person, and perhaps a chain store legislation might pop up again. So the things that we're monitoring is, if I learn of anything, I'll make sure that I advise the board on anything that is happening. Otherwise, if anybody doesn't have any questions.
Yeah. Again, I think that's all, is just looking to see what the you know, new governor, you know, a lot of changes this year, and just it may not be, hopefully there'll be no surprises, but maybe if there's some type of productive things that maybe have been ignored, maybe there's a possibility they can be pushed through this year.
We're looking forward to a good year this year.
Yep. Okay.
Okay, thank you very much.
All right, thanks, Pete.
Thank you.
And I don't see a Community Alcohol Coalition representative, so they must still be on vacation. With that, close the meeting. So I'd like to entertain a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. Meeting is adjourned.